visitor? What do I say? It's been so long since I've had company. Oh, it's you. What a surprise. Not a lot of other folks come and visit these parts. I should have known. You should already know me, but just in case, my name's Larry. I was here to be closer to my son, William. Every time I came back to these woods, I could feel him again. If only I could tell him how sorry I am. That's enough about me. We're here for you. These woods hold the answers to your questions. Everything will be explained soon. And this time, please pay attention.
so happy we decided to go camping. It's so peaceful in the woods.
William's axe. I remember taking him to town, letting him choose his first axe. Once we got back to the cabin, he couldn't stop trying to cut down every tree in the woods. There'd be nights it would get so quiet, all you'd hear are the birds and the sound of that axe like a heartbeat outside. fire brings people together out here. You understand. When the chores around the cabin were done, William would always beg to get a fire going by the river. Of course, it always started out as a much larger fire than we needed for our little pit. Nothing to distract you. No worries, guilt. We were at peace with the world. This is where it all ended. This is where I drunkenly fell asleep and failed to protect my boy, William. Because of me, he drowned. I should have been there to protect him, but I cared more about the bottle. Have you ever found yourself feeling like you're being watched? I decided to go to the lake and catch some fish for dinner one night. I had caught a couple when I got this sense that something was watching me. I know bears roam these parts, but this was not a bear. I could feel it across the lake staring at me. I got up, reeled the line in, grabbed the fish, and went inside. I've never felt like that before. So empty without William, but it's held up well over the years. Look at this garbage. They were laughing at me. Told me to go back to the cabin and stay out of the sun for a bit. There is something, or someone, watching me out here. Why did I think they would believe me? They need to be warning the people not to come into these woods until this has been solved. There is something happening out here, and no one will do a dang thing about it. Why was somebody bringing chemicals out here to the woods? That bottle you're looking at is what started this whole mess. That's when I knew I wasn't alone. Turns out mine wasn't the only cabin out here anymore. But next to that cabin, though, was a cage. But it wasn't empty, and it weren't no bear. It had fur, gray and black, like a wolf. But it also had skin, rough, like a man. I couldn't make sense of what I was seeing. I grabbed this bottle, hoping I could bring it to the police. Maybe then they would believe me.